For your mercy. We thank you for your love. We thank you because you covered us as we slept on last night. You allowed us to wake on this morning, God, to wake up, to open our eyes, to give you glory and to give you praise. We thank you, God, because you've been so, so good. And we thank you on this morning. There's none like you, oh God. There's none like you, God. And we just want to say thank you. Thank you, because you've been so good. We love you on this morning. Have your way in the service on this morning. Have your way in us, oh God. Have your way through us this morning. Let no flesh glory in your sight, but that you get glory on this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have your way, God. We bind every adversary, every evil spirit that tries to come and hinder on this morning. We lose freedom to praise you on this morning. We bind those spirits even now in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is against you. Loose your hold in the name of Jesus. We speak freedom. We lose freedom. We lose freedom to praise you on this morning. We need you, oh God. We need you, oh God. We need you, oh God. Come into the room. Have your way, oh God. Let the glory of your presence fill the room on this morning. Somebody needs you. There's deliverance that's needed. There's healing that's needed. Have your way, oh God. In the name of Jesus, let souls be saved on this morning. Come into the room. Save souls. Heal. Deliver. Set free, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we calling on you. Calling on you, Jesus. Calling on you, Jesus. Jesus, have your way. Jesus, deliver on this morning. Jesus, set free on this morning. We give you glory. We give you glory. We thank you for what you're going to do. We thank you for what you're going to do. Hallelujah. Because we know if you here, it won't be business as usual, but that you'll get the glory. Get the glory on this morning. Get the glory on this morning. In the name of Jesus, let your anointing flow. Let your anointing flow through the singers, oh God, through the praise team, through the choir, through the musicians, oh God. Let your word go forth on this morning. Oh, let the pure word go forth, God, that souls will be saved, that souls will be delivered, that souls will be set free. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we thank you on this morning. We thank you in advance. We give you a prophetic praise. Hallelujah. We thank you, oh God. Oh God. Have your way, have your way, have your way. Have your way in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, oh God. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, oh God. And we call it all done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Put the those hands together and bless him, for he's worthy. Hallelujah. I'm going to read in your hearing Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. May the Lord bless the reading of the word. You're now in the hands of the praise Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah to your name, oh God. Hallelujah to your name, oh God. Hallelujah to your name, oh God. Glory to your name. Woo! Well, here we go. Y'all ready to worship the Lord in this house tonight? Well, come on and put those hands together. We are going to sing unto the Lord. Bless his holy name. We'd like to welcome you to the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ. Praise and worship. keep playing. And you keep clapping. And you keep clapping. And you keep clapping. Come on. Hands together. Don't stop. Don't stop. Can't wait on us. It's personal. Hands together. Hands together. Deserve his goodness. He's yet good. And I give him glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just begin to lift your hands and give him some praise. Is he worthy? Has he been good to you? Has he been good to you? Tell him how good he's been to you. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, thank you, oh God. Thank you, Lord. All right. Let me do this right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord won his praise. He won his praise. He's worthy. He wants his praise from his people. No. He don't want to have to beg. Pump and prime you. Give him praise. Because he's worthy. He's worthy. Worthy of praise. On this morning. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. First, give an honor to God, to the pastor and the first lady in their absence, to all the mothers, to all the elders, to all the saints. It's good to be in the house of the Lord on this morning. I'm sorry. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's good to be in his presence on this morning. Somebody didn't wake up this morning. Somebody didn't have an opportunity. Somebody been laying in the hospital all week, just desiring to sit where you sit. So that's something to be thankful for. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I bless him on this morning. I bless him on this morning.
At this time, we're going to ask that Sister Carrie Jones come with the acknowledgement of visitors and announcements. Let's say amen for her as she comes.
Good morning. At this time, if you're visiting Lighthouse for the very first time, would you please stand and remain standing while we recognize you? If you're visiting Lighthouse for the very first time, please remain standing. God bless you. God bless you. We'd like to thank you this morning for choosing to enter our doors and come and worship the Lord with us. We hope something is said that will encourage you on your Christian walk. Our greeters are coming. They will give you a visitor's packet. Please fill out the information in that packet, and you can leave it with the ushers, or you can leave it on the offering table. And on behalf of our pastor, our first lady, and the entire Lighthouse Church of God in Christ, we'd like to thank you, and please, please come again. I have a few announcements, but at this time I have two oral announcements. Mother Thomas will come first, and then Sister Hayes will be second.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We are the mothers in the Lighthouse. Mother's counselor. One mother counselor to stand with me as I make this announcement. We are getting ready to go to our annual luncheon. We used to go on Christmas, but this time we didn't go Christmas, so we're going to go a little after Valentine. And it's going to be on Saturday, February the 18th, from 1 to 3. And it's going to be at Golden Corral, 1540 North Cocker Hill, Dallas, Texas. And we're going to come to the church on next Saturday at about 12 and going to leave by 12:30. And Brother Craner is going to carry us that don't want to drive. He's going to carry us on the bus. That's amen. But we are asking some more to come go with us. We need at least 25 people so we can get a room and off to ourselves, so we won't have to sit with other people. So if you want to go, all we got to do is see me today or call me and see missionary Laverne Allen so we can put your name down. We need at least 25 or more. It can be more because the room sit 40 people. So anyone can come and go with us. You all can sit down. And the price is $11.99 plus tax would be $12.97. So just let me know anytime today or anytime this week, please, as soon as possible, let us know that you want to go because we need 25 or more people. And you do not have to be a member of the Mother Council. You can just want to go with us and have a good, good, good time with the mothers. Let's say amen. 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 And let's please pray for Mother Merle Oliver. She is sick with the flu. I also would like to pay homage to my husband, Brother Hayes, whom I have seen grow into a strong spiritual person in his walk with Christ, even more since we've joined this church here at Lighthouse. His walk has become so real, and I am so grateful to God for it all. I had to try to think of a scripture to come with this. I'm going to try to make it a scripture to coincide with what we're going through right now. And what came to me when I was at work for a little bit yesterday was Matthew 6:33. Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all things will be given to you. And I have been seeking God for this man to be where he is today. But I've also
been praying for something even more, which this church has allowed us to be a part of, and this is what I'm giving to. I would like to thank Sister Carrie Jones for allowing me the opportunity to express my excitement about the married couple ministry. This class is something I have been asking God to bless my husband and I with for quite some time now to help us grow stronger in the Lord as a couple. I believe it is beautiful to have like-minded couples join together in worship and fellowship to gain knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of being married in Christ. It is my pleasure to invite more married couples out here to join us every Tuesday at 7:30, hosted by Brother and Sister Jones, here at the Lighthouse Church. Our first book we are reading is The Five Love Languages by Gary Chapman. I'm excited to see how God will transform us to be greater in our marriage. I hope to see you there. Also, I know that the 14th is Tuesday, and that is Valentine's Day, but we are still having a class, so please come out and join us. Thank you.
Good morning, Lighthouse. All right, first of all, Mill Chorus. It was asked that we sing this Sunday. Well, for Sunday. So in preparation, we're going to have rehearsal next Saturday, which is the third Saturday, and also the fourth Saturday, because we have a request. I Recommend Jesus. I Recommend Jesus by the Canton Spirituals. So y'all put that in your books now. I Recommend Jesus by the Canton Spirituals. So I want all y'all to listen to it. So when we come to rehearsal, we'll have it. And those that don't come to rehearsal, y'all listen to it. So y'all going to be up in the choir stand too. All right. Next, youth choir. Youth choir. We're going to start rehearsing on Wednesdays. Y'all hear that? On Wednesdays, okay? So y'all bring your kids out. Parents that are in the choir, bring your kids with you. Because we will be rehearsing. We will take one of the rooms or the chapel. We're going to rehearse with the kids, with the sanctuary choir, okay? So that'll be every Wednesday till we get back on our feet. All right, every Wednesday, youth choir, 7:30, every Wednesday. Y'all got it? What'd I say? Every Wednesday? All right, thank you.
Can we say amen for those announcements? Amen. At this time, I'm coming with just a few more announcements. Please pray for Mother Gill and Mother Perkins. Sister Calhoun has given me this little pamphlet. She says she has a few more of them for anyone. Free tax preparation for individuals and families making up to $54,000 per year. She still has more of these pamphlets if you would like to have your taxes prepared. This comes from Sister Edwards. All ushers, please make your annual reports to Sister Ogilvy as soon as possible. And to add on to Sister Hayes' announcement, on this Tuesday nights are looking different for us. She's already talked about the MCM, Marriage Couples Ministry, but we'll also be having our financial, part two of the financial planning class. We'll also be having Yes, Youth Enjoying Service by Sister Cynthia Mann. And we've added a singles ministry class that will be taught by Sister Christian. So Tuesday nights is very exciting, and Bible study. We will be having Bible study. So please come out and enjoy what God has in store for Lighthouse for the new year of 2017. There are more announcements in the bulletin. Please govern yourselves. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot one. Sister Henry wants to see the nurses' unit. Do you know where you want to see? Today after service, right here where she is. I'm sorry. Let me say that again. Sister Henry would like to see the nurses' unit today. All righty. I think I'm done with all the announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. And at this time, I'm going to give it into the hands of our First Lady, Sister Clinton.
before I make this presentation, want to see all the tribe captains today. Classroom number one is very important. It won't be long, but I really do need to see you, okay? The annual Women's Day is first Sunday in March, all right? Licensed missionaries, aspiring missionaries, please text me. If you received your letter, text me, call me, email me, all right? I'm looking for you, all right? Thank you. At this time, as Sister Hayes was saying, Tuesday is Valentine's Day. And for those that just love to celebrate, I love Valentine's Day. I love my husband. Y'all know that. And he loves me. But but I stand. I am not in this position. I pray that God will never let me get in that position. But my my heart went out to those that are divorced. Not divorced, excuse me. Not divorced. Delete widows. And really just want to let you know that God loves you. I love you. And the church loves you. But I want to personally, this is most time we always do things with pastor and myself. Today, I want to do it for myself. I will ask if all those that are widows, if you would stand. If you are a widow, would you please stand? Just want to give you a little bear hug and some little sweets to say that you are loved and you are not forgotten. And the person that you still love and that want to let you know so much. You don't have that person to buy the little sweets. You have your children. And the children will do what they're gonna do. But I wanna say that I love you, I appreciate you, and that you are not forgotten. And so just wanna give some little love to those that are little. All right. Thank you. If someone is not here, it's only for those here today. All right? If I run out, all right, don't be trying to get some that ain't here. Thank you.
We thank God for our First Lady. She's very, very considerate. Let's give her a hand. It's very important sometimes when you feel by yourself and somebody can say, you know, I love you, I appreciate you. That's very kind. God bless you. At this time, it's time for the Ministry of Giving, so we're going to ask the pastor and the deacons to come at this time. Let's say amen for the pastor at this time.
Bless you on this morning. We honor the Lord, and certainly we honor each of you that's present this morning, to the elders, ministers, and men of the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ, to Lady Clerkley, to Mother Thomas, to all of you, the people of the Lord. We thank God for you. We thank God for his presence and his spirit. And we thank God for all that he is and all that he is doing even right now. We're going to ask the men, those persons who are going to serve this morning, if you would come. Saints, it is offering time. that us celebrate the Lord with our tithe and with our offerings on this morning, as God has prospered us to give. You're so blessed to share a $20 gift, a $50 gift, a $100 gift on this morning in the general offering. We pray that you would do that to honor God's house, your tithe, your offerings, those things that you have purposed to do. We pray that you would do that on this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Brother Collins, if you come on this side, you and Elder Livingston. Father, we bless you this morning and thank you for this blessed opportunity that you give us to come together in worship. God, we believe that part of worship is not just giving in song, not just giving in dance, but it is also giving our substance, our monies, our devotion. And so we sincerely consider this worship. Worship the Lord with our giving. Worship the Lord with giving our heart. Worship the Lord with giving him our song. Worship the Lord with giving him our obedience. And Father, we thank you that we have something to present in worship. I pray that you bless every gift and every giver. Cause it to be returned even as you have promised, some 30, some 60, some even in hundredfold, in this world and the world to come, eternal life. Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Would you stand all over the house, beginning at the rear, begin coming and sharing your offerings, your gifts on this morning.
Never change, yeah. Said the word. just forever settled.
All righty then. Forever settled. Ah, Lordy. Hallelujah. Can I just need to encourage? Let me just. There is an agenda for today. Have you ever seen in the movie where the person, it's almost like they're hanging, and the person is trying to save them. And you see them, the hand is slipping. The fear is, I'm going to fall. And they keep saying, hold me. And the person is saying, I got you. But you need to use the other hand. You holding on with one hand. I need you to reach up with your other hand and hold on with both hands. But I need to encourage, and it's not one person. It's not one person. You holding on, but you only holding on with one hand. You're only holding on with one hand. The Lord is saying, if you'll reach up with that other hand, if you'll reach up with that other hand, your other hand's really not. I'm not supposed to preach this morning. Elder Edwards is supposed to preach this morning. Really didn't feel 100%. This morning. Still don't feel 100%. But since I ain't my boss, y'all understand? I wanted to, you know, but since I ain't my own boss, but God is saying the reason so many people are slipping, it's not they're not holding on, but that some of what's on your hand, some of where your hand has been, is causing your hand to slip. You ever notice in the Olympics when they get ready to do certain things, they put chalk? The purpose of that white powder is to dry their hands so that even their own personal sweat, your body produces oil. It is a very normal thing. But when they're getting ready, because they need to, for what they're going to do, they need a sure grip. They put chalk on their hand to be sure that they don't get in their own way. That what naturally happens doesn't hinder me. Can I tell you that your very natural emotions, to be angry, to be upset, to be disappointed, to be in love. Your very natural emotions can cause your hand to become slippery. Because you're trying to hold on to God with emotional hands. Your emotions, your issues, your discipline. I ain't got nothing up here because I ain't got nothing up here. Eh? My fan and this, and I'm supposed to be sitting down. But your natural, those things that being upset is natural. Being emotional is natural. Being in love or wanting to be is natural. But when you allow that is natural to interfere with what God is trying to do. The scripture says in Corinthians 5 and 17, I believe, if any man be in, he is a new. And those things that controlled you, the emotions that control you, help me, Lord, because I don't. The emotions that control you, that make you not want to, as natural as it may be, you can't let it control. The emotion that says, I don't feel like preaching this morning, makes my hands oily. And the Lord says, oh, so you decided that on yourself. The emotion that says, I don't feel like going to church this morning because, makes your hold on God oily. The emotion that says, I need to step down and not work right now. I feel just a little bit better. The emotion that says, I need to step down, I need to take a sabbatical, makes your hands oily. The emotion that says, I can't get along with, so I'm just going to mix your hands. Now, the emotion is normal. It is very normal. But when you declare that you are saved and I sold myself out to God, you cannot let your normal emotions take control and then tell the rest of you what to do. We have allowed very normal. I'm not saying what you feel ain't normal. I'm not saying what you feel is not normal. But I cannot be controlled by my normal feelings and then be controlled by the Spirit of God. It becomes a tug of war. Praise me. I don't feel like it right now. Worship me. But I'm going through right now. Give me glory. But this ain't my day. Honor me. But I just got off the phone. And if you knew what I was going through, when the emotion of going through blinds you to who you're going to, the emotion of going through can cause you to be blind to what you're going to. And when you become blind to what you're going to, panic sets in. Disappointment sets in.
depression sets in. All these emotions that all you felt naturally was, I don't feel like it. But you didn't realize that when you started not feeling like it, there were some other things that came along that you didn't realize was coming with your, I don't feel like it. You just started out, I didn't feel like it. You didn't know depression was coming. You didn't know vexation was coming. You didn't know I'm tired of all that. I'm tired of being the only one was coming. So here you are on your way to the choir. Sing this morning. Oh, I don't feel like it. What's wrong? Oh, child, you just don't want to know. Well, look like you got some stuff going on. Nah, I don't know why you trying to read me. I'm just saying, look like you got some stuff going on. Nah, child, I told you, I just don't feel it. You know what? When you're going where you shouldn't be going, you really don't see what's behind you. Can you see what's behind me? I can't. You can see what's behind me, can't you? I can't. You see what's behind me? I can't. You see what's following me? So why do you get upset when people see? Thank you, brothers. Thank you. Rather than saying, you know what? I need prayer. Rather than saying, I just, you know, I have been. And I probably just need to pray right now. Rather than make up another excuse. Rather than skim over the truth. Because your natural emotion. Jeremiah had a very natural emotion. I don't feel it, but I feel better. Jeremiah had a very natural emotion. His natural emotion was, I am called to preach to the political arena. I'm called to preach to the priest. I'm called to do all of this, and every time I do it, it gets me in trouble. Look at where I am right now. I'm in prison. Live safe. I'm in prison. Preach the gospel. I'm in prison. Obey God. I'm in prison. All the things he said do has now landed me in prison. So I decided I ain't gonna preach no more. Is there anybody in the room that decided ever in your saved life, ever in your called by God life, you ever decided I ain't no more? And while you were in the I ain't no more, the Holy Ghost began to stir. And you didn't want to, I don't know if you've ever been to church before, Sister Rogers. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know if you've ever been to church before and decided I ain't going to praise him. Ain't saying good all day long. Ain't going to praise him. No, I ain't going. No, I ain't going. I wish they'd sit down and stop singing because they trying to get next to me, but I already decided I ain't praising him today. I wonder if he, I'm about to, is there anybody that just decided I praise God, and every time I tried to live for God, all this ever got me was hell. Every time I praised God, all it got me was broke. I tried to praise God, but all it ever got me was death. I tried to praise him, but every time I did it, I'm tired of being laughed at. I'm tired of being talked about. I'm tired of not being chosen. I'm tired. I'm going to find me another church. I don't understand that God is trying to work a work in you. Hallelujah. But you got some oil on your hands, and your hand is slipping, and you trying to figure out why I can't hold on. Why is it I can't hold on? You know, I used to be able to hold on, but look like it's hard for me. There's some folk in this room right now. Their real testimony is, I used to be able to live saved longer than this. I used to be able to rebuke the devil better than this. I used to be able to do such and such better than this. Look like in this situation, it's just harder to live. There's some folk in here right now that have that in their mind. It's harder to live saved today than it's ever been. The devil is a liar. You trying to say that the Holy Ghost don't have the same power today that it had in 65. You trying to say that the God that I serve is not the same. The Bible. Yeah. This wasn't my intent, Elder. This wasn't my intent when I got up. I honor you, sir. I absolutely honor you. You don't realize that what you're saying when you say people can't and people don't, you're suggesting that the anointing of God can't save like it used to. You know, used to when people come down to the altar, they got delivered. Used to when people come down to the altar, they got prayed through. Were you at the altar? Why they not delivered? You at the altar? How come the devil didn't get cast out? You at the altar? How come the devil didn't leave here? You at the altar? How come they didn't leave out of there? You at the altar? Why didn't? Realize we got oil on our hand. Hebrews 13 and 8 declares Jesus Christ the same. Jesus Christ, the same. When is he the same? Yesterday. Conjunction. And today. Double conjunction. And he's the same. Yesterday. Conjunction. And today. Double conjunction. And so if he's the same, why isn't my relationship, why is it my hold on him is not the same? All the hands. Natural oil that emits from your body. The natural oils that emits. If you got a chair and you keep putting your hand on that chair, after a while it gets grungy looking. Just not because your hands are dirty, just because the natural oil. If you have a desk and you keep, wherever you keep your hands at, it begins to show because of the natural oil. So how do you look sanctified when your natural proclivity is to be dirty? When my natural emotions makes me look and say, boy, she sure look pretty. Oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. I'm saved. I'm married. When my natural emotion as a boy, my natural emotion, don't laugh at me, Clifton. you went back to Palestine or something. Talking about, I knew you then. When your natural emotion stands next to the Holy Ghost and they look at each other, your natural emotion looks at the Holy Ghost and the Holy Ghost looks at you. Now, the Holy Ghost ain't gonna say nothing. Can I tell you why? You already know what God said.
Already know.
You knew when you looked at her, you was married. You knew when that thought came by, you was married. You, so the Holy Ghost, so then you look at the Holy Ghost and say, I mean, it's all right, ain't it? I mean, you know, pretty is pretty, ain't it? I mean, just, you know, it's all right to window shop as long as you don't go in and buy, right? How often do you get angry? And that part of you says, say something. Say something. No, I'm going to let them go this time. And they do it again. You said, see, they take you for a sucker. They taking you for a fool. You better say something. Because if you don't, your mind never talked to you. If you don't say nothing, they're going to use you for a doormat. They just going to keep on doing that. They just gonna keep on. If you don't say something, if you don't let them know, you the one saved, they ain't saved. You better say something. Let them know that you ain't nobody's fool. Let them know you ain't nobody. You ever stand there arguing with yourself to say something or not to say something? And then you walk away, and then somebody come up and say, you know why they think you scared of him? I ain't scared of him. I ain't scared of her. Yeah, man, everybody's saying the way he treats you, man, anybody else would have slapped Brian upside the head. Your next statement is, let him keep on messing with me. I'll let him know that even saved folk have bad days. All the hands, the very normal and natural emotion of being vexed, offended, and upset. It's natural, it's normal to be offended and upset. But you cannot be spiritually controlled and then controlled by your emotions. God, don't save me from lust. Don't save me from cigarettes. Don't save me from drugs. Save me from me. I can take the desire for drugs away, but you still got to deal with you. I can take away the lust, but you still got to deal with you. I can take away your anger, but you still have to deal. We never ask God to deal with me. I need you to deal with me. Deal with that thing that's down on the inside that makes me do this. Stop dealing with that stuff on top. Lord, I can't control my anger. That's because you can't control you. It's not your anger, it's you. Lord, I just can't help it when I, that's you. Lord, help me deal with me. The Bible says in the book of James, I ain't supposed to be preaching, Mika. The Bible says in the book of James, the tongue is an unruly member. Member of what? Your body. Go up, hand. Go up. Go up. I said go up. Isn't there something your hand won't go up just because you said go up? Move, feet. Isn't it something that the members of your body obey, and your tongue gets unruly. Why would the Bible say unruly? Well, you just say aren't there other words the Bible could have used? Those of you that read the Bible, Elder Edwards, couldn't it have used another expression rather than the tongue is an unruly member of your body? It's unruly. Think about it. It called it unruly. Your tongue is unruly. Peter is with Jesus on a Mount of Transfiguration. God comes down and manifests himself, and Peter gets excited because his tongue is unruly. You know, we need to be a monument up here. We need to be a... Peter, shut up. Because some of you think that you're in the presence of God, and God will... It didn't happen to Peter, and he was there with Jesus and God and the Holy Ghost. So now Peter can be there with God, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost, and his tongue don't. See, when you get the Holy Ghost, you won't be. Yeah, right. So tell me why you repented the other Sunday. Tell me what you were crying about the other Sunday. I need to quit. Especially since I wasn't supposed to. So next Sunday, pray that Elder James Edwards would be able to preach and declare the word of the Lord. Next Sunday, third Sunday, the men are going with me. I pray the male chorus go with me to Palestine. It's our time to go to Palestine. Not just the men, but their cheerleaders go with us. That means you wives. We got a charter bus. Sister Precious, the Mayberry said he needs somebody to tell him he's on the wrong, right note. All right, that's next Sunday, so we'll have Elder Edwards preach. I woke up this morning, I told Sister Clerk, I said, you see me jump out of bed? She said, yeah, you jumped up and you just, she said, what was up? I said, I couldn't remember what day it was. I couldn't. I stood there, okay, so what did I do yesterday? Okay, so then the day is, can you get so overwhelmed that you just, yeah, and I thought to myself, yeah, that's exactly why Elder Edwards is preaching this morning, because I can't even figure out what day it is. And then he says, no, you still got to. Do you understand what it means to be bought with a price for the word of God to declare I'm no longer my own? Can I tell you, the Holy Ghost won't hurt you. It really won't hurt you if you just let go and let God have his way. I'm stopping right there. Bow your head. Thank you, choir. Thank you, praise team. I love you guys so much. Music staff, musicians, appreciate you guys. I know if take that nasty plunge, you guys are always there, and it's just, there's such a comfort that I have with you guys. Bow your head. Jesus. Oily hands. I'm slipping, God, because my hands are oily. I'm slipping, God, because I'm thinking I can hold on to you with one and do something else with the other. And yet the truth is, you've called me to be holy. You call me to hold on with both hands. Both hands. Both hands. Not just
The challenge, Lord, is not you holding me, for I am persuaded that there is nothing that can separate me from you. But there's so much that I allow to disappoint me that if I'm not careful, I can even reject the very hand that's come to help. If I'm not careful, my pain will make me reject the very hand that's come to help. If I'm not careful, I'll reject the very hand that's come to pull me out of my darkness and my depression if I'm not careful. And so, God, here I am. I've got all the hands. That doesn't surprise you. You're my maker. But I need help. I need help with my oily hands. I'm a missionary. I'm a preacher. I'm an elder. Truth is, God, I need help with my oily hands. I'm a praise leader. I'm a choir director. People count on me. And sometimes struggle is simple. I have all the hands. I'm a musician. And it's important that I be there to play on the instrument. It's a part of the worship. And sometimes it's not easy for me because the oil in my hands. Sometimes the oil in my hands. That is the right song, brother. Whoever that's playing, that is the right song. So I need help. Ain't no sense in me looking at Sister Clerkley when I'm the one that need help. There's no sense in me looking at the prayer warriors when I'm the one that need help. It doesn't matter how well they pray. There is more work done when I pray. It's one thing to come down here with everybody. It's another thing to come down here and simply say, it's me. It's not the choir, it's me. It's not the Church of God in Christ with all them rules. It ain't the rules, God. It's me. Right now I'm vexed. Right now I'm discouraged. I'm disappointed. They want money that I don't have. They want me to jump rope, and I did that before. They got all these rules, and I'm just so sick and tired of the Church of God in Christ. Truth is, Lord, it's really not them. I'm frustrated. The frustration is in me because if I could do it, I'd just do it and wouldn't say nothing about it. I wouldn't even deal with it. But I've allowed it to frustrate me and not realize that I've stepped back, stepped away. And so I bless you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for hearing me. Got no fancy words. Got no these and thous. That ain't the way I really talk. It's just me. Barefoot me. Nappy-headed me. Just me. And I need your help. If that's you, I'm going to ask the prayer persons to come down and just come across the front. I'm going to ask the helpers to come down and just be here across the front. If that's you, I'm going to ask you to come down. On one side, just everybody on one side, Ella Mayberry, that I'd rather you be on this side. I don't know what kind of oil is on your hand, and I'm not even asking what kind of oil is on your hand. I'm just going to ask you to come down here with your hands lifted and let them pray with you and pray for you. Just come on down and let them pray with you and pray for you. I'm not asking you what kind of oil is on your hand. I'm just saying preachers and pastors need prayer. And when we stop pretending that we don't need it, maybe more people can get help. Missionaries, elders, and evangelists need help. And maybe if we just admit it sometime, rather than me praying for somebody, I need somebody to pray for me. Just come down.
To be whole. I want to be right.
Your hands together. Clap your hands and thank God. Thank God. Thank God for this very unusual but very appropriate service on today. God bless you. God bless you. At this time, there may be somebody here, amen, and you don't have a church home. I would like to, at this time, open the doors of the church. There's anybody here today and you don't have a church home and you would like to become a member of the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ, we would like to invite you at this time to come down. Amen. We would love to have you as a member of the Lighthouse Church of God, Church of God in Christ. Amen. If you're here and you would like to be on the watch care, you haven't made up your mind yet whether you want to be a member, but you want to be here under watch care. Amen. We would also like to, for you to know that the doors are open for you. Amen. Let's clap our hands and thank God for this sister. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. And your name is?
Sharon Cunningham.
Sister Sharon Cunningham. Amen. And you like to be here under watch care or as a member?
As a member.
As a member of the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ. Praise the Lord. On behalf of our pastor, this grand pastor here, Pastor Clerkley, our first lady, Lady Clerkley, amen, and all of the Lighthouse family, we welcome you as a member of the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ. I would like for some of our sisters that would, if you would come on down and make her feel welcome, amen. I don't see Sister Fuller, amen, that would be, yeah, there she is, amen, amen. Come on down, saints. Those of you that, yeah, make her feel welcome here at the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ. Thank God for her. Yes, she's been here on the watch care for a while already, but now she's a full member of the Lighthouse Church of God in Christ, and we thank God. We thank God for her, amen, being a part of our family. Amen. God bless you. The Urshan's Annual Day Program will convene this afternoon at 3:30. What did I say? 3:30 this afternoon. Amen. We'd like to see you back. Amen. And we're going to celebrate our Urshan's Annual Day. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Did you enjoy the Word of God on the day? Oh, my God. Amen. God bless you. We're standing all over the building. God is good. Hallelujah. Again, we thank God for all of those that came as visitors today. Don't let it be your last time. Come back and be with us again. And now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost be with you and watch over you until we meet again. All of God's people tell him thank you. God bless you. Greet one another on your way out, and we'll see you about 3:30 this afternoon. All of the Women's Day, Annual Women's Day captains.